Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. In this video, we will discuss the fourth objective from this subtopic, that is to determine the trigo function for any angle. Before we do that, there are four basic knowledge that you need to have first. The first one is positive and negative angle. The second one is quadrant. The third one is basic angle. And the fourth one is ASDC. We already covered point 1 and 2 in subtopic 5.1. If you are still struggling with these concepts, make sure you clear your understanding first before you proceed with this video. There will be links down in the description for you to go back to those 5.1 videos. The last two things that you need to have before we can get to this video's objective is basic angle and ASDC. Let's see basic angle first. Basic angle is an acute angle, that is, angle that is less than 90 degrees with the horizontal line. If you have an angle in the first quadrant, the basic angle will be here. If you have an angle in the second quadrant, your basic angle will be here. The same with third and the fourth quadrant. In the third quadrant, it will be here. And in the fourth quadrant, it will be here. Some students make hilarious mistake when spelling angle as angel. So, using that common mistake, we will use that as a way to remember the position of basic angle, or should I say basic angel. Look, a literal angel. So make sure to bring this trigo angel when we discuss solving trigo next. Find the basic angle for 120 degrees. We know that 120 degrees is in the second quadrant. The basic angle should be here. We know that this is 180 degrees. That means our basic angle here is 60 degrees. Let's try again. What is the basic angle for 210 degrees? I will delete this one first. 210 degrees is in the third quadrant, here. And this is our basic angle. Since this is 180 degrees, that means the basic angle for this is equal to 50 degrees. Now, let's try one more question, and I'll let you try this question on your own. What is the basic angle for 300 degrees? I'll hold the video for 3 seconds. You can pause this video if you need more time. Let's check your answer. Since 300 degrees is in the fourth quadrant, like this, our basic angle is here, and we know that the complete rotation is 360 degrees. That means this basic angle here is equal to 60 degrees. Now, let's see the fourth item that we need for this video, ASDC. ASDC is one of the ways to remember in which quadrant does the basic functions, that is sine, cos, and tan, becomes positive. Starting with quadrant number 1, it's A. Quadrant number 2 is S. Quadrant number 3 is T. Quadrant number 4 is C. This means in the first quadrant here, all basic functions are positive. In the second quadrant, only sine is positive. In the third quadrant, only tan is positive. And in the fourth quadrant, only cos is positive. There are many ways to remember this from your high school. Add sugar to coffee. All science teachers are crazy. No offense to all science teachers out there, you guys are crazy awesome. But for me, Aztec will do. It's up to you how to memorize this. Now, let's get to the objectives of this video, to determine trigo functions for any angle. Let's see some questions. We want to simplify sine 220 in terms of acute angle. On another word, we want to simplify this into its basic angle. The first thing to do is to sketch its Cartesian plane, like this. The second one is to draw its angle and determine its quadrant. We know that 220 degrees is here in the third quadrant. The third thing to do is to find its basic angle. Our basic angle lies here. Remember the angle? Since we know that this is 180 degrees and this is 220 degrees, this basic angle here must be 40 degrees. So our basic angle here is 40 degrees. The fourth and last thing to do is to find its positive or negative by using aspect. So we know that this is A, this is S, this is T, and this is C. Since this here is in the third quadrant, only tan is positive. Our function is sine, that means the sine here is negative. So, to simplify this term here, we need to write it in this form. We need to have its sine first, and then its function, and then its basic angle. So, the sine is negative, the function is sine, and its basic angle is 40. So this is how we simplify the term. We need to have its sine from aspect and then just copy its function from here. And then we're going to simplify its angle by using basic angle here. Still confused? Let's see another example. Cos 490. Remember our steps? The first thing to do is to sketch. The second thing to do is to determine its quadrant. So let's sketch first. So 360. 490 exceed the first rotation here. But that's okay. All the steps are still the same, even if it's in the second rotation. So this is 360. This is 450. And this is 540. So 490 would be in between that. So we know that this is in the second quadrant. The third thing is to find its basic angle. Remember this? So this here is our basic angle. Since this is 490 degree and this here is 540 degree. That means our basic angle here must be 50 degree. And lastly, we need to put aspect in our diagram here. So this is A, this is S, this is T, and this is C. So our angle here lies in the second quadrant with S. That means only sine function will be positive here. Our function here is cos, so in second quadrant, cos will be negative. So let's simplify here. The format will be sine, function, and basic angle. So, simplifying this, the sine for this is negative and the function here is cos and the basic angle is 50 degree. Now, this time we're going to look at negative angle, tan for negative 108 degree. To test your understanding, I'm going to try to simplify this trigonometric term first on your own. We will discuss this question again in our next video, but make sure to try it first. So, until then, thank you for your attention, have a great day, and take care.